Greetings, dear friends, and welcome to the Blue Cube YouTube channel. In this lesson, you will first learn about the different types of strokes, then you will learn how to work with the line tool, and finally, you will be taught how to design with the pen tool. Okay, friends, I will create a rectangle. The stroke of this shape is currently black. If I select the shape with the free transform tool, I can change the stroke color from here. Choose any color you want for the stroke. Also, if you have seen the previous lesson, you will remember that you can choose the gradient mode for the stroke from here. In the previous lesson, I fully taught you how to work with gradients. For example, I will consider this gradient mode for the stroke, and now you can change the stroke colors in the color panel. The color of this part will be green, and by double-clicking on this slider, I will choose yellow instead of black. Since I fully taught you the color panel in the previous lesson, I will not go into this section anymore. I'm going back to the Properties panel. I select the shape again and choose the color black for the shape. We can also decrease or increase the stroke opacity. From here, I can reduce the stroke alpha. If I click on the document, you can see that the stroke opacity has decreased. Now we can see the document from under the stroke. If I zoom in a little, it becomes clear that the stroke transparency is much lower. Okay, I'm going back to the previous state. I select my shape again and set the alpha value to 100%. Now instead of the stroke of the shape being a straight line, we can choose different styles. For example, we can use a dashed line or other styles. When I select the dashed line, it may seem at first that no change has been made. But if I decrease the stroke size and zoom in on the shape a bit with the zoom tool, now you can see much more easily that a dashed line has been created for the stroke. I increase the stroke size again and you can see the dashed line. But to adjust the dashed line, we can click on these three dots and select the Edit Stroke Style option. Here I set the spacing and size of the dashes. First I make the dashes smaller and then I set the spacing of the dashes. After making the dashed line settings, we click OK. Now you can see that the spacing of the dashes has increased. I select the shape again and increase the stroke size. I can go back to the stroke style section again and choose other types of strokes from here. For example, you can select dotted. This way, you can replace the regular stroke with a circle or other types of stroke. I select the shape. There are other stroke styles here. You can also use these ready-made strokes. Okay, I select the normal stroke. The next option is to set the stroke width mode, which if you click here, there are different modes for the stroke width. See the changes here. I select the normal stroke again for my shape. From here, we can determine whether to scale the stroke horizontally or vertically. There are also normal and none options. I choose normal. What is important to us here, my friends, are these six options. First, I return to the initial view to see the document in its entirety. Note that the shape is selected. In the lower part, the miter join option is active, which creates sharp corners for the stroke. By selecting this option, I can choose the broken mode for the stroke. The difference is quite obvious. Or you can select the round join option for the stroke. The difference becomes more apparent when I make the stroke larger. So you can choose a round, broken, or regular stroke. But there are also three other options here that do not change anything when you select them. These options work on the line. So I will create a line with the line tool. Note that if I hold down the shift button, a perfectly straight line is created. Now I select it with the free transform tool. I make it smaller. Now, my friends, pay attention to the beginning and end of the line. You can see the changes on the line by selecting each of these options. You can round or break the beginning and end of the line. These tools are very helpful in design. I press Ctrl and A to select the shapes and delete them. I select the line tool again. I make the stroke size smaller. If you hold down the left click and the shift button, the line is created straight. Also, if you hold down the shift button and drag the mouse down, you can rotate the stroke or line 45 degrees and make it bigger or smaller. If you hold down the Alt button, the line is smaller or larger from both sides. Finally, if you select the line, the same settings that I explained previously exist for the line. In short, you can choose the color of the line from here, make it bigger and smaller, and change its style and width from here. Now I select this line and delete it. Now I select the pen tool. If I right-click on the pen tool, there are other tools that we will discuss. First, I select the pen tool and click to create a point. With a second click on the document, a line is created. The reason the line is not straight is that I changed its settings before. So I press Ctrl and Z and go back. I select the pen tool and reset its settings to default. I click on the document several times and create lines. If you click the left button, broken lines are created, and if you hold down the left button and drag, you create curved lines in this way. When the line is curved, two levers also appear that we can change by holding down the Alt button. In this way, I can correct the lines. When I have corrected the line, I can hold down the left button and drag and continue my work in this way. And finally, I click on the starting point of the line to close the shape completely. My friends, the pen tool is a very important tool that we use a lot for character and scene design. Also, if I come and right-click on the pen tool and select the Add Anchor Point tool, now I can click anywhere on the line to add a point to the line that I can change the line again. I select the Subselection tool and change the location of the points in this way. You can select any point and change your shape. I right-click on the pen tool again and select the Delete Anchor Point option. Now if I click on any point, that point is deleted. In this way, I right-click on the pen tool again and select the Convert Anchor Point option. Now by selecting any point, I can make changes to the shape and lines using these levers. Remember that in order to use the Convert Anchor Point tool, you must first select a point and then drag to apply the changes to you. If we select the pen tool and hold down the Alt button, we can make changes to the lines much more easily. Now I press Ctrl and A to select all the lines. I increase the stroke size and change its color. You can do the same settings that I taught you this time using the pen tool. My friends, if you look at this corner, it has a broken state. We can choose the round state from here. Changes are applied easily. Okay, my friends, I have told you all the points and topics related to this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to practice with these tools yourself to fully master them. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button or the subscribe below the video, and please like the video. Goodbye for now.